My next speaker is Dr. PNVSV Prasad, who will come and discuss about some Jugaad and quick fix methods in orthopedics. Come, Dr. Prasad.
Good morning, everybody. Till now, you have seen what not to do, and I'll show you how to escape in times of trouble while in the theater. Dr. Kirpat told, we are like lions. Yeah, we are like lions. But with the courage of the lion, but leave about the ego the lion has. Just now, the previous speaker has told that the conservative methods, but these are the days of internal fixation. So the non-indications have become relative indications, and relative indications have become definitive indications, and sometimes even non-indications like this, an undisplaced medial malleus fracture, have become jumped to definite indications because of our necessity to survive, or what we can say, something like that. And at the same time, this change has happened because of many factors. Some of them are patient related. When I started my practice about 30 years back, when I advised surgery, is it necessary? The patient question was. But now, if I ask them to go for conservative treatment, the patient is asking, is surgery not needed? Something like that. So the patient attitude has also changed. And some are technology related, because we get better implants, not like the one before with the SP pin, which used to break every time and goes for varus at the junction of the nut and the pin. Some others are surgeon related and can be due to the following reasons. The supplier might have supplied a different implant. This because of communication gap, the OT staff might have kept ready a different set of instruments and implants, and mistaken decision making, omissions and commissions of the surgeon, wrong positioning of the implant, lack of skill and training. With the lack of training, we are doing interlock nails without any nuts, bolts on either side of the nail, or with normal screws in locking plates, so on and so forth. And you can see a interlock PFN without any screw on either side. You know, with all the above problems, we are still managing because of our patients' tolerance. The rural people are very tolerant, not like the urban crap. As the first speaker has told, that rural practice, they don't ask anything. They just come and they listen and they get treated whatever you give them. Some surgeon factors are like mistaken decision making. I don't know what went wrong for putting a plate at that level or for putting a nail at that level, but the surgeon has chosen to put a nail from below where he has fractured the lower end, shattered the posterior cortex, and he has done a wiring and then inserted the nail, and the reduction is not good. There are butterflies. And intercondylar supracondylar fracture, this has been nailed with some CC screws, but the reduction is not good. The nail is started migrating instead of plating. Another case of segmental fracture, extracapsular fracture femur, and then a shaft fracture, which could have been managed by a recon nail, but he has done a DHS and then another plate, which got a large, big incision, and then the reduction is not good, and it went into non-union. So it has been corrected by long PFN or recon nail. You can see this I already shown. And another thing, he has not put two screws at the distal segment after nailing of the humerus, which he might have avoided the upper one, but definitely might have locked the lower one. And I don't know what happened. He has not even tried. There are no holes seen. Trial holes are also not seen in this. And wrong positioning of the implant because of lack of training. He has put the nail in a reverse direction. The curve should have been on the anterior aspect and ended up with recurvatum deformity. Another case of nailing upper third, and this is the final result, and lower third femur, and this is the result. This is all because of lack of skill and orientation to the surgeon, whoever is doing, and they should be trained properly before doing surgeries. And another case, the surgeon thought that these implants are fixing the fracture, but these two implants are in the proximal segment only and not connected to the distal segment, and it is equivalent to conservative treatment, except that the screw and K wire is there in the this thing. And another case, minimally displaced fracture, he tried to put a malleolar screw, but it's not there in the malleolus. His lateral, it is looking good, but here it is not there. And the orientation, he has missed both the holes and put only one screw in the distal segment, which is supposed to have one more screw, but he has put only one screw, and then I don't know what happened. Almost the length of the nail is incision size. I don't know whether he wanted to put it from this side, from sideways, or from above, I don't know exactly, and ended up not putting any screw on both sides. And even the jig is looking, usually the screws will be from lateral to medial, but it is looking in an AP view. So even the orientation is not there, got infected. And putting an external fixator, there is no loosening here observed, but the trans pins have gone very much deep inside, and you can see the deformity correction has been managed with only two pins, and there is increased deformity of the femur. And some instrumentation problems, the jig might not be matching because of previous surgeons hammering on the jig elbow rather than on the hammering part. Using a non-cannulated bolt in place of a cannulated bolt, faulty dynamic holes, and faulty designing of the implant. Some of the examples, jig is not matching. Usually the proximal screws will go properly, but the distal screws will not go. But here, even the nearest holes are missing by the jig. You can see on both sides. So don't take loan of your instruments, but try to have your own instruments so that you will keep them safe. Another case, I was pushing the nail inside after guide wire, but it was not going. Then I checked in the CM, I found that the guide wire is twisted like this. Then I noticed that the cannulated bolt is having a block there and it is pushing along with the guide wire. So I removed that, and then I used a different this thing for finishing up. Have you noticed any difference in this? So your observation skills are more important. Yeah. I don't know, anybody has seen this before, but I have seen this somewhere in Greece or somewhere, but I don't know how they use it. What is meant for that? Even today I don't know what is it meant for, which is supposed to be like this. No, sir, it's not photographic. I have seen live. That is what I am saying. I have seen live, and I don't know how it escaped the quality control. No, sir. I have seen it live, and I have photographed. I myself have photographed. It is not from... I myself have photographed. I have seen that. That is what I am saying. but there should be something other one, no, by the side of that, but that doesn't have that, no. So have you noticed anything in this? Anybody can say that, have you noticed any difference in this? It is a regular AMP. Have you noticed anything in this? By putting this, I was struggling to push it inside. I could not push the after reduction. I could not get reduced into the acetabulum. Neck is very long. This is also not normal. The neck is very wide, not like this, so that it prevents movement. Even this will come into your inventory sometimes. And this is a normal neck with a too much. So you should observe before putting any implant into patient. You should observe what you have, and you should be able to detect what is the problem that you are going to face. Have you observed anything in this? It is written as 135, 4 hole, short barrel. This is not 135 plate. Yeah, true. This is 135. It is written as 135. The person gave me this and I tried to push it. I could not push it. And afterwards I matched. This is, both are 135 marked. I measured. This is 120 only. This is 120. This is 135, but it is marked as 135. And then I trying to put it. I could not put it. I removed that. And then I checked with the guide wire. I thought that the person might have put a guide wire in a different direction, but the angle guide is matching. So then I removed the angle guide again and then pushed another plate that is matching. So don't believe anything that is there in the inventory of your instrument table. And have you noticed anything in this? Both are? This one. Does it look like 135? One thing. The next one is, the tip of the nail is well below the tip of the trochanter. What mistake that the manufacturer might have made? He has asked the person who is manufacturing it, the technician, put a 135. What he has done is, he has done, instead of 135 to this, he has put 135 to that. And then made two holes, and so that became 142 instead of 135. So I was struggling to put it inside, and unless I go deep inside, I could not get into the center. So all these things may come into your this thing also someday or sometime. And static lock is there, and where it is supposed to be? Above. But where is it now? So both are static locks practically. There is no, even though there is a dynamic slot, both are static locks. And the more clever thing is, he has put it at the center instead of one side. At least 1 mm compression will be there or 2 mm compression will be there. He is more clever like this. Instead of putting to one side, he has put it to center. And here it is to the opposite side. This fellow is not clever. So all these problems may arise. So you should be prepared for all these problems during surgery. Some patient factors are extremely narrow cavity, severe bowing of bones, small bones like in poliomyelitis, congenital abnormalities, and fractures around amputation stumps. All these previously shown slides were some of the causes for searching for alternatives during the process of the treatment. Simplest form of treatment, he doesn't want any sutures, he doesn't want any major surgery. So, like Arvind was telling, it is bound to slip. Either I can put an interlock nail, or otherwise it will slip. What I have done is, because he doesn't want surgery, I put only 2 K-wires or 3 K-wires, and then put a cast, and it united well. What is the difference? Nothing. It is almost, patient is functionally good, there is no disability, there is no deformity, and I could manage with simple 2 K-wires. The supracondylar nail was not available at that time, but I felt that the interlock may not hold it. So at that time, the gamma nail was available, which I have reversed, and then put it in the, from the entered into the, from the distal end. Supracondylar nail was only available, imported nail was available, which was costing at the time maybe around 8 to 10,000, but this nail was available for 1,000 rupees. So, beautiful union, there is no deformity. Another case with an amputation stump here, this is totally amputated, and I could not put a short femoral nail. And PFN nails, they were having holes here, these 5 centimeters are free. And so I have selected a supracondylar nail with a 25 centimeter supracondylar nail, and then I have locked it at the tip, and I could get away, good union. A humerus nail has been used in poliomyelitis, where the marrow is very narrow and there is good union, good functional. This fellow has come to me for deformity correction. There is varus at the hip and valgus at the supracondylar area. Very short, femoral nail could not be accommodated, and I wanted to do a abduction osteotomy at subtrochanter level and then adduction osteotomy at the supracondylar area. I want to do both at the same time. So I have selected a recon nail and modified with shortening and then different holes at the distal point. I have shortened the nail and measured and shortened the nail, but while pushing it, I could not go beyond this point because I thought that this hole will come into the next segment if it goes fully inside for locking of the middle segment. But I could not go beyond that, and I checked in the C-arm and found that it is tightly fitting there. Further hammering will break the bone. So I have left it like that with one hole and a little of this thing. I have done the adduction osteotomy at the supracondylar area and then fixed with it. Afterwards, I have observed that a PF nail will come with a short length, but a recon nail will come with a long nail. I could have selected this for remodel modification, but this will not have a additional hole. That is why I have selected that, but I could not go beyond that. So you should consider all aspects while remodeling of the nail. And he was done, because he is short, he has been done, performed a osteotomy at corticotomy at mid-third tibia for lengthening, and lengthening has been achieved. And you can see this deformity has come gradually to this. But he requires a femoral lengthening, but he doesn't come for femoral lengthening. That is why his bum is up above the toilet. Another case of achondroplasia with 110 degrees of neck shaft angle in AP view and 135 degrees of neck shaft angle in lateral view. She came for lengthening of tibia, which was done before. She also had increased lumbar lordosis that has been corrected with an abduction and extension osteotomy at the subtrochal level. And I have modified the humerus nail because the marrow is very narrow. I have modified the humerus nail and then additional screws here and additional screws there. And neck shaft angle has been corrected to 135 in AP and 160 degrees in lateral use, and lengthened with Elizaro apparatus, and gradually there is distraction. One side I used number 8 nail, this was stuck, and one side I used 7 nail because this was stuck, and so I have to do a re-manipulation under GA and then pull it down, and gradually that has been consolidated and good alignment of neck shaft angle, but the 7 nail has broken at the modification level. Another case of osteotomy for hand to knee gait was done before in polio case, but this has malunated. This is the initial picture. So I have done a fixator assisted deformity correction with modified humerus nail because this is very small marrow, and so you can see the zig and nail has been modified, and you can see good union with modification of the nail. Usually in humerus you will see both the screws in one direction, but I have put another screw. I didn't dare to put two screws in the anteroposterior direction in this. Another case, usually upper end of the tibia, I prefer instead of a regular nail which contains only two holes or a UTN which is very costly, I prefer a supracondylar nail reversed and then put it into the tibia. But if this is available only from 9 number, but if the marrow is narrow, you cannot do this because that will be, if 8 is accommodating, the marrow is accommodating 8, you cannot do this. This is more stable because of the two lag screws and very good union. And how do I do this is I take lateral entry, lateral to the patellar tendon, entry lateral to the patellar tendon, and from the top, instead of these newer nails coming suprapatellar approach, I felt that this is better. Just shift the patellar tendon slightly medially while taking the entry point, and then this is the entry point, go like this and pass the guide wire. And once you insert nail, you will have a step here. So this much of from the anterior cortex of the distal fragment, from the anterior cortex of the proximal fragment, this is the step that is remaining with the nail inside, even if you have taken a entry at the upper point. So what I do is, this is touching the posterior cortex here. So this is the distance that I want the nail to migrate, or the proximal fragment to migrate posteriorly. So I put a K-wire there, mediolateral, like this, and then insert the nail. One polar K-wire, not even screw, and then there is good reduction, and then lock it, and you can remove the K-wire on the table itself. Another case, a long oblique tibial fracture. On the table, sir, this much long right side plate is not available, only left is available. What to do? You cannot get them. So I have stabilized with a CC screw initially, got reduction of the intraarticular surface. The opposite side, left side tibial plate has been kept on the medial side of the tibia, but these screws will not reach the lateral cortex. That is why I have stabilized this, because the angle of the plate is anteromedial to the posterolateral. The screws will go posterolateral. They don't cross, because the lateral surface of the tibia is straight and the medial surface of the tibia is slopy. And so they don't reach up to this cortex. So I have stabilized that and then fixed with it, and you can see good union. You can see, sorry. You can see good union there. Another case of poliomyelitis with supracondylar fracture. But no plate will match, femoral plate will match here because of this acute angulation. The femoral slope is, and the lateral femoral plate is something like that, very much less. But here it is more. Then what I thought is, I reversed the tibia. This matches almost similar to this. And so, opposite side upper tibial plate has been reversed and put it on the lateral side of the femur, and good match has occurred and good fixation. This is intracondylar supracondylar fracture, which everybody will plate. I have shown one result which was bad, but with good expertise and good fixation, you can get away even with nailing, even in these cases. You require a perfect job. Like, you see two cat eyes here, both screws were passed in exact this thing. I prefer one at this curve and one either below or above if it accommodates. And you can see good fixation. Another cat eye, almost similar orientation, the supracondylar intracondylar fracture that has been. I have seen people fixing the supracondylar fracture with this type of fixation with the screws above, but I prefer this because the cross section of the femur is rhomboid in this, and the posterior opening will be there most of the times. So I prefer a posterior stabilization which gives more stability compared to the anterior stabilization before passing the nail. And I have shown you something before, and so one surgeon has fixed with one screw above and one screw below and non-union, and there is some anterior translation which has been corrected by passing a reverse nail. The anterior translation has been corrected, grafting has been done, three screws in the distal, two screws in the upper. Try to fill all holes as far as possible if there is instability. Don't compromise with one screw above, one screw below, because anesthesia is saying that the time is over and the anesthesia time is up, something like that. So with judicious execution and knowledge about the size, shape and angle, availability, many implants can be used at different places than they were meant for. But one should know the stability of the implant is giving at the other site and the immobilize the limb accordingly when used in polio limb. Limb is of bigger size compared to the bone quality, and the implant is meant for a lower sized limb, and so the failure chances. Do not promise the patient that he will be able to walk immediately after the surgery. Many surgeons, because they want to attract the patient, no, you will be able to walk within 3 days. I will make you walk within 3 days, something like that. Don't promise them. So that gives a false this thing, but you may face the problem afterwards. Promise only that the best possible will be done, and it is the duty of the nature to heal. Ask them to take rest for better results, like in fever, where they give rest for early recovery. Know the heart of your instrumentation and the implant, like you know the reactions of your better off in different situations. You can get away even in situations like this. It's not mine, but I got some from somewhere, others. If you are judicious about immobilizing the patient, multiple L wires were put in tibial fracture, and there is good union. And this is the worst nightmare of any orthopedic surgeon, subtrochanteric spiral fracture, which has been managed with multiple simple screws. And there is a split in the vertical split in the upper segment, and the entry point is having a contaminated wound, so I could not put an interlock nail. There is a split, this is extending like this. So I have put an Ender's nail from below, but I thought that this segment will shatter, so I put a CC screw and another CC screw, and one ender has been passed anterior to that and one posterior to that, so that it interlocks the proximal segment. Thank you.